Hi friends, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. Today we will learn how to write a program to calculate the nth Catlin number. Catlin numbers are a sequence of natural numbers that occur in some interesting counting problems, like count the number of expressions containing n pair of parentheses which are correctly matched, count the number of possible binary search trees with n keys, count the number of full binary trees with n plus 1 leaves, triangulation of n plus 2 gun, handshake problem. The beauty of Catlin numbers is it occurs in various counting problems. We will look at two interesting problems and different approaches to solve it. Problem 1. Count the number of possible binary search trees with n keys. Case 1 is to find number of possible binary search trees where node is 1 and key is 5. There can only be one solution where 5 is selected as a root node. Catlin is an array that stores nth Catlin value, so Catlin of 1 is 1. Case 2 is to find number of possible binary search trees where nodes are 2 and keys are 5 and 6. There are two possible binary search trees. Either 5 is selected as a root node or 6 is selected as a root node, so Catlin of 2 is 2. Case 3 is to find number of possible binary search trees where nodes are 3 and keys are 5, 6 and 7. There are three choices at first view. First, if 5 is selected as a root node, then either 6 or 7 can be used as next node. Hence, possible binary search trees are 2. Second, if 6 is selected as a root node, then possible binary search tree is 1. Third, if 7 is selected as a root node, then either 5 or 6 can be used as next node. Hence, possible binary search trees are 2. Total value becomes 5, so Catlin of 3 is 5. The logic behind drawing possible binary search trees is to choose one node at a time as a root node. If 5 is root, nodes at left side is 0 and nodes at right side are 2. So, Catlin of 0 into Catlin of 2 is 2. If 6 is root, nodes at left side is 1 and nodes at right side is 1. So, Catlin of 1 into Catlin of 1 is 1. If 7 is root, nodes at left side are 2 and nodes at right side is 0. So, Catlin of 2 into Catlin of 0 is 2. We get Catlin of 3 as 5. Case 4 is to find number of possible binary search trees where nodes are 4 and keys are 5, 6, 7 and 8. Case 4 can be directly solved using this simple logic. There is no hassle of drawing possible binary search trees. Catlin of 4 is calculated by choosing 4 different values of root node. When root is 5 plus when root node is 6 plus when root node is 7 plus when root node is 8. So Catlin of 4 becomes 14. This code is the implementation of recursive formula we discussed. We declare the base case as Catlin of number less than or equal to 1 is 1. Else, for each ith number, recursively keep adding the value of Catlin of I into Catlin of n minus I minus 1 to res variable. At the end, we return res value. We should notice here that Catlin of I is selected from first I numbers and Catlin of n minus I minus 1 is selected from remaining numbers. To consider all the subset of items, there can be two cases for each item. The item is a root node, the item is not a root node. We can observe that recursive implementation does a lot of repeated work. It computes Catlin of 3 twice. Since subproblems are evaluated again, this problem has overlapping subproblems property. So recomputation of same subproblem can be avoided by constructing array Catlin in bottom-up manner. We can use dynamic programming for this. This code is a dynamic programming based implementation to find nth Catlin number. We have declared Catlin as an array to store results of subproblems. Catlin of 0 and Catlin of 1 is initialized to 1. For rest of the numbers, we compute Catlin by selecting each I till I is less than or equal to n using this recursive formula, where jth node is selected as a root node in each iteration. Catlin of j is selected from first j numbers, and Catlin of I minus j minus 1 is selected from remaining numbers. At last, return the value of Catlin of n. Thanks for watching. For any queries or doubt, please comment below.